If you sell products and you haven't listed them on your Google business profile yet, you could be hurting yourself. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, it's Bryan Caplan here with BiggerBetterBiz.com, and I wanted to bring your attention to something that was added recently to the Google Knowledge Base. This is something that maybe you hadn't picked up because you're probably not reading the knowledge base that often, but it's a huge update and you need to be aware of it. Before I get to that, let me just walk you through some of the best practices or the expectations that Google has when it comes to your business profile. And really, these are things that are going to help you increase your odds of showing up in the local pack or on Google search maps above your competitors. First off, always make sure that your profile is complete. In my Grow with Google classes, when I'm talking about building your profile, the big thing is making sure you fill out every single field. They're there for a reason. You are building a profile, almost like a dating profile, on Google, on the number one search engine in the world. You want to make sure that you're giving them as much information as possible. So that's number one, make sure you enter your complete data. Two, verify your location. Listen, your profile is not going to show up if you don't verify it. Usually you verify through a postcard, you request it to your physical mailing address. If you work from home and hide your address or you're a service-based business, you would request a postcard to your house. Doesn't mean that your address will show up. The thing here is you may also have the ability to verify by phone. Some people have been verified by email, and now Google has kind of added on or kind of reintroduced verifying through video. So if you see those options and they're faster than the postcard, definitely do it. You need to be verified in order for you to take advantage of the features and functionality in the Google Business Profile and to show up so that people can find you when they're searching for your products and services. Keep your hours accurate. Big thing, one of the stats that I teach in the Grow with Google class is that 40% of searchers are looking for your hours of operation. That most likely has increased. That was a stat from maybe 3 or 4 years ago. So you're going to want to make sure that you are keeping your hours up to date. Not only your Monday through Sunday hours, but also holiday hours, making sure that you mark off any days that you're going to be closed. Manage and respond to reviews. Big one, we're not gonna cover that today. It is something that you should be paying attention to. In fact, you should be actively requesting reviews. You should be managing those reviews, responding to them, and promoting them, sharing them out. If someone gives you 4 or 5 stars and, you know, screams to the heavens that you're the best thing since sliced bread, you better be sharing that. That is great marketing collateral. That's good content. So you wanna make sure that you're not only requesting reviews and growing your reviews every month, but also responding to those reviews. Adding photos, the big thing is that consumers, we're visual. Humans are visual by nature, right? So if we can see photos and or videos, we can process those photos or videos much faster than the written word. So if you're going to be telling me about, you know, you're a tailor and you can fix any type of shoe, or you can fix, or you're a cobbler, or if you're a tailor, you can fix a tear in a pant, or you can redo a Louis Vuitton bag. Yeah, you could write it in a paragraph, or you could show me a before and after. The more photos you have, the more informational touch points you're providing to potential customers. That's what Google wants. Those photos and videos, those visual cues, make you more relevant, and it also gets customers more excited to do business with you. So, rule of thumb, I'll just tell you should have at least 5 photos. You should be adding at least 2 to 3 more every month. If you can add more, do it for sure. The last one, and this is the big one. This is why I made this video, because Google just added this section, and I want to walk through it with you. Add in-store products. Now, you have to understand, Google, at the end of the day, it's a search engine. People are searching in their moment of need. We call them micro moments, a moment when a consumer needs to know, go, do, or buy. Well, if they're looking to buy, wouldn't Google most likely show a business or a business profile that is actually displaying all of its products? It makes your business profile more relevant to that searcher in that moment. And Google, YouTube, all of the different properties are really focused on user experience. If Google can be relevant to people searching, then Google is necessity. People need to use Google because when they have that micro moment, they have a pain point or they need a solution, they can turn to a search engine like Google, type in what they're looking for, and ultimately find that specific organization, business, so on and so forth. By adding your products in, not only are you feeding Google more information about your business, which is advantageous, but you're also presenting those products to your consumers. If they're not looking for your brand name or your address or your business category, but rather a specific product you have, by adding those up to your business profile, you increase your chances of showing up. We're just basically, think of it as a fisherman that's casting a net. If they cast a butterfly net, if they took a little butterfly net and just went into a pond, maybe they'd catch a minnow, who knows? But as they start getting bigger and bigger and bigger and they start adding more data points or information points, photos, reviews, products, that net gets wider. The wider that net gets, the more fish they're gonna catch. And if they can catch more fish, well, let's liken it back to you. That's more customers, it's more revenue. So this is a huge addition, and do not look past this. You need to add products to your Google business profile if you haven't done it already. And if you have, make sure all your products are up to date and make sure you have every single product in your business profile. Now I'm gonna be making another video soon enough about a special device. It's actually a company that Google acquired. You're gonna wanna watch that video because it's a device that you can request and then you'll be able to automatically, through your point of sale system, add all of the products that you have without having to manually enter them. It's basically as simple as a scan. Won't talk about it today, but for right now, I want you to focus on adding those products. Make sure that you're actually following all the best practices I just went over, and hopefully you're going to increase your odds of showing up on Google Search and Maps. Until next time, I hope that you stay well, stay healthy, stay happy, and of course, here's to your success.